So let's say you have a transform of this. I have e to the 2t times u of t minus 7. Okay? Well, again, what I want is these arguments to match up. I want this to be this, right? Well, I'm gonna do, I always don't want to make it true. So what I'm going to do is this. I'm going to write this as t minus 7, which is what I want, and I'm going to add the 7, right? I'm going to break this up. I'm going to add some couple steps here that you probably don't need to do, but just so it's clear to everyone. This is going to be e to the 2 times t minus 7, right? Times e to the 2 times 7, which is going to be 14 u of t minus 7. Okay? Right? 2 times this, 2 times 7. What makes this nicer is that e is a constant, so we can actually just pull it out front. It's part of what's going to be, if you had linear, it's part of that getting a linear transformation. If you haven't had linear, well, that's the integral operator, actually. You know that as well. So you pull the e to the 14 out. And then you have the Laplace transform of e to the 2 times t minus 7, u of t minus 7. Okay? And again, what I would do here is, I would deal with the u right away. So now it's going to be e to the negative 7s, right? And then I'm just going to kind of lock in on my function. I already dealt with the shifting, right? So I'm actually taking the transform of just this. So that's going to be 1 over s minus 2. Okay?
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.